Thanks, Travis. I'll have Jay pay you for that. If it's okay with you, I'd like to talk with you just about 10 minutes, hit some of the high points, and then go to some questions and answers, because I know there's some things on a lot of people's minds, and we want to make sure that we get those things. So first, thanks so much for giving me the privilege to represent you in Washington right now. It's certainly a unique challenge in the country, none more so than the economy and jobs. And I want you to know, in Washington, there are those of us that do believe the deficit and the debt is the greatest threat to our children's futures as Americans. And I happen to be one of those, and we're going to continue to work to drive that deficit and that debt down. We spend about $10 billion a day in Washington. We're taking in a little better than 7. Now, we've done this for the last 4 years. And there's a big debate in Washington over whether or not we're going to cut that budget down or whether we're going to increase taxes. And I'm going to tell you, the bottom line is you're not going to cut it far enough to balance it. You're not going to raise taxes far enough to balance it. The only way to balance this budget is to create jobs in this country. And we're going to have a big debate over the next several weeks on the corporate income tax. And I want you to know just how little the corporate income tax generates in revenue for this country. 2011, it was $181 billion. I want you to think about that. We spent $10 billion a day. About 18 days of total federal spending. Think about how many companies we have in this country that would expand if that tax went away, how many jobs would be created. Think about how many companies would move from overseas to America, and how many jobs would be created in this country if we just got rid of it. It's 18 days of total federal spending. It's not about corporate America versus the American system. It's about how we get Americans back to work. And the divide that's been created in Washington, quite honestly, is shocking. So when we go forward over the next couple of weeks, you're going to see a lot of us pushing to say the absolute fact that the total corporate income tax is only 18 days of total federal spending, and if we got rid of it, we would get rid of the deficit because we'd be able to get America back and forth. Now, there are a couple of other things that are going on there, too. A lot of talk about Brian. We were at Moody Air Force Base this morning. I want you to know, as a member of the Armed Services Committee, I think that you will see a round of Brian in 2015. I don't think the President will insist on it until that date, but I do think that that in 2015, after the midterm elections, that you will see him hold to a round of Brian. I'm glad that you put together the Military Affairs Committee. And I want you to think about this. We need to be in the Military Affairs Committee talking about how we grow our base, talking about the assets that we have. We've got great infrastructure out there. We've got two great runways. We've got the ability to grow with that base. We need to come at this from the standpoint that we know there will be a bracket for the next 3 years, and let's go get what we can get out of it. So let's get our assets together. Let's get together a plan, and let's find the missions that we can go get to bring to this area and actually grow that base. The other thing I want to talk to you about is the health care bill. A lot of debate over shutdown or no shutdown, September 30th. You see, our fiscal year ends September 30th. By the way, that's 9 legislative days from today. 9 voting days from today is the end of the fiscal year. There's no budget. There's no continuing resolution. There's no appropriations measures passed September 30th, 9 legislative days from now. A lot of talk about the Affordable Care Act and holding it in relation to the continuing resolution. Here's what I want to tell you about the Affordable Care Act. October 1st is when the rates are published. That's an important date because that's when Americans get to see exactly what it's going to cost. I quite honestly think that we need to get a short-term continuing resolution passed, because of all of the things that we have to get done between now and the end of the month, and then we can have that debate after the rates are published and the American citizens see exactly what it's going to cost. And when I say after, I mean 45 to 60 day continuing resolution, having that debate before the end of the year, but again, after the American public sees what it's going to cost. And I think that when they see those numbers, it's going to change their opinion. legislation. With that said, Myrna, you want to call some questions?